Junior, number 20, Sadie August. Junior, number 18, Clary Braun. Junior, number 2, Tori Mecca. Junior, in goal tonight, number 27, Chris Dinaya.
Good evening, and welcome to Weston High School. Tonight we've got a broadcast with your Greenwich Cardinals as the visiting team taking on Weston. Not really sure what their school is. It might be like the Weston Knights or something like that. First time, to my knowledge, that these two teams have played each other in a long time. Cardinals are coming off a win against Stanford early this week, and I believe Weston's coming off a win against the Weston Trojans, but Weston's coming off a victory against big school Newtown, 5-4. And now we've got the playing of the national anthem. All right, we're going to get to live action shortly.
It's a beautiful night up here in Weston, Connecticut. This is Neely Messer signing in with David Roth. Feels like a little Friday night lights.
Without a doubt. Glad you can make it.
Should be a good game. I just joined David. I don't know if he mentioned that Weston is currently undefeated. And they won last year.
They won their small school state tournament.
Okay, so although they're playing Greenwich tonight, which in theory is a bigger in a different class school, this should be a good matchup for the two teams.
Right, and their game this week at Newtown. Newtown is a larger school, similar size to Greenwich, Connecticut, as far as in the state tournament. So. You don't need to have a big school to have a good lacrosse program. Speaking of programs, didn't Darien just beat your alma mater?
Yes, Darien did beat St. Paul's School for Girls from Baltimore, who had traveled up to Darien, Connecticut. I think this is the second year in a row that they've played against each other. St. Paul's had started the game up. Darien was sort of having a hard time adjusting to the shot clock, but they figured it out and came to life and ended up beating St. Paul's School for Girls, which I think now has given Darien the number one high school spot.
Correct. Yes.
So pretty amazing to think that our girls on the Greenwich High School team are competing against some of the best girls in the nation. I mean, between Darien and New Canaan and Wilton.
The FCAC is probably one of the stronger conferences in the nation.
And then throw in local competition like Greenwich Academy, who we scrimmage, and Sacred Heart. I mean, really, we are seeing top competition and top players who are attending the top lacrosse programs.
And here we go with live action. Abazia taking the draw. Looks like Collier and DeGennaro are on the circle. And Abazia wins the draw. That's Tower who got that ball. that's McFerrin who brings that ball into the offensive end. And that ball goes off of the stick of Greenwich. The goalie from Weston is committed to play lacrosse at Vandy. And Weston gets that ball into our offensive end.
So we've got Weston working the ball around the 12-meter.
Looks like they're setting up some type of some drive down the alley. Maybe not.
Katie Janis in goal for Greenwich. Nice defense there from freshman, is it Annabelle DeGennaro?
Correct.
Who was number 27, I believe.
And a nice save by Janis. I think one of the defenders might have gotten their stick on it also.
Oh, nice check by Greenwich. Let's see who can come up with this ball. Oh, oh.
And that's Adorney fighting for it. And Weston comes up with it.
They seem to like to do this sort of...
That looks like that was Mia, I guess, Feldman from Weston who came up with that ground ball.
Weston's doing a good job of staying very spread out. Sort of got their five players well out behind the 12-meter and a few people popping around inside. Taking their time. Grayson Islanson with some good defense, keeping the Weston player to the outside. Oh, and a nice save by Janis.
And we're going to get a foul on that shot, which should put number five, that's Sarah Zwack, on the 8-meter. I'm guessing that's probably going to be the center hash from where she drove. Actually, it's not an 8 meter. Actually, it is. Sorry.
Oh, and somebody got a stick on that.
Good job. And then nice outlet pass by Janis. She gets it up to Abazia, and they've got some numbers. And a nice shot from the outside by Abazia. Hits the top corner. That was probably outside the 12, I think, that shot. So... Cardinals draw first blood, get the first goal on the board. It all started with a good defensive play on the 8-meter and a very heads-up outlet pass by Kate Janis to a streaking Mambazia.
Yeah, I agree. Kate Janis definitely got that play going because she was able to get it up above a lot of the Weston players that gave us a fast break opportunity, which we didn't need to take advantage of because Abazia went to goal and had a beautiful shot and scored, which leads us at 1-0 Greenwich with 8:30 remaining in the first quarter.
And the sun is coming out, and there'll be no complaints on the sidelines for that.
Have to do a redraw here.
Should we do that? And Cardinals get that draw. Abazia gets it to DeGennaro, who gets it over. That's MK Fry. And that's Roth, who's got the ball. She's pressured. And that's Abazia with the ball.
Oh, wow. An excellent check.
And a nice ground ball by Fry. Clearly, you're seeing Weston is looking to really pressure the ball. And then we get some type of whistle. I think it might have been a 3-second violation of number 11. I'm kind of curious how the sun might be affecting some of the players. And we have a stoppage of play. You know what that was called for?
I don't know what that was, David. You know, it's interesting. I was wondering if it was another 3-second on number 11.
And it might be because she's going behind her, so I think you're right on that.
Which, it's interesting how in the last game that you and I called, you know, we had all those calls about being in the crease.
Yeah.
Maybe this referee's got something for the 3-second rule. Anyway, Greenwich able to take advantage of that.
And that's Abzi, and she's going to get doubled behind the goal. So they're actually playing. Good drive by Collier and a nice save. And I think we're going to get a foul on that shot.
David, did you mention that this goalie is a senior who will be attending Vanderbilt in the fall? Or?
Correct. And for those casual observers at home, she is actually a lefty.
Greenwich has been doing a great job with their ride the past couple games, really putting a lot of pressure
from all
the attackers.
Nice job by Louis Nagaki on that one. And that looks like that was a good ground ball pickup by Sophie DiPietro.
Dylan McFerrin to Aubrey Roth.
So they quickly send a second girl down with a girl pressuring out.
So oh, good pick
Cardinals
up
are going to have
DiPietro.
To move the ball quickly and actually look to double. And that was a nice play, patient play, actually. Abazia finds DiPietro in the seam.
Yeah, Sophie DiPietro for the goal and Abazia for the assist on that.
Yep. And as you were mentioning, it kind of started with the with a good aggressive redefend by the Cardinals.
Yeah, they seem to be bringing all their attackers kind of to the 30 and then just trying to pressure anything that passes through. Anyway, that was a great example of a good redefend with a pickup, I believe, from Lily Nagaki that got the play going.
And if you notice, like, Cardinals were skipping a player on that pass, looking to pass into a seam. And we got movement early on Abazia, the Cardinals. So that will give the ball to Weston. And a shot by number 5, Zwack. I thought O'Connor was closest to the ball, but that ball is going to get awarded to Weston. That looks like number 8, Kayla Schiffer. Good defensive play. Annabelle DiGennaro picks up that ground ball. She gets it to, that's Lindsay Messer, the old Greenwich speedster. And
that was good upfield movement. Now Greenwich working it around.
Yep.
The 12. Woo! Wow.
And a nice feed from, that was Nagaki, to Abazia in the middle. And what
bullet.
We've seen already is with the way that Weston is looking to pressure out on the girl with the ball and send a second girl there as a backer, they're leaving the center, they're leaving the middle open. And if the Cardinals continue to play patient.
That's the problem with the backer is you know, if they're so focused on the girl with the ball, it's easy to kind of sneak behind them. And that's what has happened, I think, two of these three goals today. So let's see if they readjust their defensive strategy going forward.
Looks like Messer's on the circle right now with DeGennaro. And Abazia taking the draw. And a nice play by Abazia. That ball goes out of bounds, but it will stay with Weston. And that looks like number six with the ball. That's Hannah Cross.
So yeah, that was a nice draw control by number six for Weston.
And we're at 4 minutes to go in the quarter.
With a score of Weston 0 and Greenwich 3.
That was a nice play by number 8 from Weston. That's Kayla Schiffer, one of the seniors.
They've done that a couple of times, David, where they've taken it 1v1 from behind, and Greenwich needs to adjust to make sure that we bring the double a little bit faster.
Yeah, she took her outside a little bit and then was able to cut inside, and it was really tough for any of our defenders to help out on that one. So let's see, any changes out there? Looks like McFerrin is on the circle right now with DeGennaro. And DeGennaro comes up with that ground ball. She gets it to Giselle DiPietro and to Sophie.
Gotten Leighton Collier with a skip pass to Aubrey Roth. Leighton Collier with a feed to the middle and a shot from Giselle DiPietro that makes it into the goal.
And true to form, Cardinals have found the weakness in the middle. And right now they're exploiting that. And that puts a score to 5-1. With 3:10 to go.
Just 4-1.
4-1. There's no 2-point shot.
It's only if it hits two posts. Ha ha ha.
I didn't know if that was a joke. I was trying to be straight faced.
You were wondering if that was one of the rule tests.
Correct. And good hustle by Abazia to get that ground ball.
Yep, switching fields to Flynn Tauber. Dylan McFerrin, Aubrey Roth. Again, working it around the 12-meter.
That's Collier up top. That was a good look and a nice defensive play.
Weston goalie clearing the ball. Let's see what Greenwich can do on this redefense. Oh, they've got triple team on her. They have to pass the ball back. They're sending it back to the goalie. This all knocks time off the clock, which is good for Greenwich.
Weston in no hurry to clear that. That's one of the differences between college and high school. And that ball goes down, and DiPietro gets it.
Oh, great catch from Abazia.
And shot by Abazia, backed up by the Cardinals. And we're approaching the 1 minute mark.
I mean, the beauty of the quick clear is trying to get that fast break. But if we can shut them down with a redefend, it sort of takes the fast break away, which is
right. Kyer picking that ball up. We're approaching 50 seconds.
Let's see if we can get one more shot off.
Finds Abazia. And a nice defensive play. And then a good redefend by the Cardinals. And we're approaching 15 seconds.
And it's Weston ball with 9 seconds.
And seven. I don't think they'll get a shot off here. And that's the end of the first quarter.
All right, we've got a score of 4-1. Greenwich leading Weston. Two goals for Emma Abazia, a goal for Giselle DiPietro, and a goal for her twin sister, Sophie DiPietro, with assists coming from Leighton Collier, freshman Lily Nagaki, and Emma Abazia. Good first quarter, although it did seem to be more on the Greenwich side than Weston.
No. And I think there's a little adjustments by the Cardinals. I think this is one of the first games that they've seen the two players behind really pressured a lot. A lot of the teams won't cover the girl behind or pressure the ball behind. Weston seems to do that, but Cardinals keeping the ball moving, and they find the soft spot so far in the Weston defense, which has been a couple of cutters underneath in the middle. I'll be curious to see if Weston continues playing that type of aggressive defense the second quarter.
Well, the sun's really a factor up here in the stands.
Well, if you think about it, if you're on the near side looking up for perhaps a high pass, the sun's going to be right in your eyes for probably, I'd say, another quarter. And we've got a couple of fans that are harassing us right now. We might need to call security. Usually we're in the comfort of a press box, which has
heat,
food service, wet bar. Today we're really roughing it.
Anyway, it's a beautiful spring night for lacrosse. Weston, beautiful field here.
And I'll be honest with you, the traffic was not as bad as I anticipated.
Not at all.
So I guess nobody works on Fridays anymore in the office, so it keeps the highways pretty empty.
And so Greenwich is going right into another game tomorrow. They will be playing Wilton High School, which is a top team, tomorrow at 2 p.m.?
I believe at Wilton at 2 p.m. Wilton is currently 3-0. They've got a game tonight as well against a team from New York, Shenandoah. But Wilton, I think right now, they're definitely ranked within the top 10 in the country right now. And they've always been a tough competition for the Cardinals. They've certainly had the best of us the last, I'd say, at least four outings that we've played them.
It's really impressive when you think about all the talent that's in Fairfield County. I mean, we used to be, you know, thinking of Baltimore and Long Island for lacrosse, but now, I mean, Fairfield County is right there with them.
And they're going to do a redraw. Here's a trivia question. What's the difference between the draws in college and in high school? The one rule that's different.
I don't know, David. What is it?
They don't, in college, they're no longer doing the we'll keep redrawing if it's not done correctly. They do go to alternate possession.
Oh.
And looks like that ball is going to go to Weston.
All right, Weston working the ball around their side of the field. Speaking of Fairfield County lacrosse, I don't know if anybody tuned in to watch the Lawrenceville game.
Nice save by Janice.
But Lawrenceville was the number one boys team in the country, and they were just defeated by Brunswick in sudden death overtime.
And what some might say was somewhat of a controversial play, as the shot went out of bounds and the goalie chased it but was beaten by the Brunswick player. And before the goalie had a chance to get back in the net, play was restarted, and they made a quick pass to one of the wing attackers who fired that shot into the net before the goalie was set for Lawrenceville. So, and a nice save by Janice again in the meantime while we're talking about that. And Collier's looking to clear the ball up the middle.
Oh, nice. Nice wheels by Collier there. She's running
she's
through
running
a lot of girls.
Through the redefend.
Watch behind there. All right, we've got it to Mary Kate Fry. We've got it to Sophie DiPietro, Aubrey Roth, Giselle DiPietro, Lily Nagaki, all on our offensive side right now.
Cardinals keeping the ball hot as they're being pressured out. A real contrast in defensive strategy. And Abazia, she tries to drive, and she gets fouled.
So we have a free position here for Abazia.
I think so, and I think that should be at the, they're going to give her the center hash, actually the one to the left. Is she going to go high or low?
Yeah, we've got this lefty goalie. I think she's going high.
Top left?
Yes.
Or to the goalie's right?
Yeah.
Our left.
She likes to shoot high. Well, that she was going for high left. I think she just missed it.
And that ball goes, and Cardinals are there to back it up. If you're new to the game, closest to the end line where the ball goes out of bounds, that team retains possession on a shot. And it looks like Weston is continuing to pressure the ball and to look to double.
Wow, Weston looked like they had three girls on Oh, beautiful.
Nice,
from
and that was
Roth.
A nice feed from, looks like, the freshman, Lily Nagaki.
To lefty Aubrey Roth.
Who finishes, and now the score is 5-1.
That's two assists for Nagaki today.
Yep.
Nice job, Lily.
Yep. Playing with the poise of an upperclassman. So I understand that there's a big Division III girls lacrosse matchup tomorrow.
Yeah, are you referring to the Middlebury Tufts matchup?
I could very well be talking about that game, yes.
Yeah, my daughter Caroline Messer, who plays for Middlebury, will be playing Tufts tomorrow. It's the only team that has beaten Middlebury in the past 2 years.
Folks
always
at home,
big
that
rivals.
That was a setup question. I was paid to say that.
So if you want to, the game is actually at Tufts in Boston. If you want to tune in, you can go to NESCAC channel and watch it live. It's starting at noon.
Go, And looks like Giselle DiPietro is on the circle with Annabelle DiGennaro. That was off of white. That should be red ball.
All right, let's see what Weston's doing with their deep. Oh, beautiful.
And a nice move by Roth.
There seemed to be a little confusion on the Weston defense there, that Aubrey had a pretty easy path to goal and a nice shot.
Well, I think when with the defense that they're running and the pressure, if people aren't set and that one girl is going out the pressure and she doesn't have any backup or slide to help, they're pretty exposed, which is exactly what happened there.
Yeah.
And so that makes the score 6-1 with 8:34 to go in the half. And I have been told that here at Weston, the concession stand is open today, and they're having a chicken nugget sale if anybody wants to head over there at halftime. Chad Messer, feel free to go over there.
Oh, I like it. Emma Abazia using the kick move.
And you now one girl is down from Weston, and we're going to get a stoppage of play. I didn't really see what happened. Looks like number 8. And that's senior Kayla Schiffer, who's, I believe she had the first goal for Weston.
Yeah, and she did. Yeah, it looks like she's hurt her leg.
Yeah, they're looking at her leg. And I don't know about you, but it just seems that this year, maybe I'm more hypersensitive to it, that there's been a number of knee injuries that you keep hearing about from girls playing lacrosse this year.
Yeah, I mean,
and locally, people that we know of, you know, and it's
probably a combination of things. First of all, these kids are playing lacrosse more year-round and using the same muscles in their body versus diversifying in their sports. And I think it's just also becoming more aggressive of a game.
And looks like she's okay. Looks like she's walking off on her own power and not being helped. So that's a good sign. And we did have a caller, someone calling on our hotline. And when we were talking about the Division III matchup, they were actually thought we were referring to the Williams-Bowdoin matchup. I can safely say that we weren't. But I don't know if anybody caught the St. Lawrence-Canton game the other night, where my daughter Kelsey Roth had a goal and assist. Now that someone opened up the Division III, you know, talking blog. But
yeah, we have a lot of Greenwich High School graduates playing at the Division III level, which is exciting. Many of them are playing against each other. We've got CeCe Tauber and Grace Collier playing at Williams. As I mentioned, my daughter Caroline Messer playing at Middlebury, the defending national champions.
Which they lost, and my daughter, one of my daughters, Sophie Roth, is playing at Gettysburg, which happened to lose to get it to Middlebury last year. But
in next, the finals.
But next in the finals. But next week there's actually a big matchup with Franklin and Marshall playing Gettysburg, which will feature MK Savio for Franklin and Marshall and Sophie Roth for Gettysburg. And that was a nice feed by Roth to Abazia, which makes the score 7-1.
That was a beautiful feed from Aubrey. A little bit higher that Emma Abazia was able to pop it in right at the top of the goal. Very nice pass. Very nice finish.
Well, and I'd be remiss in not mentioning my oldest daughter, Delaney Roth, who's down at William & Mary.
Delaney also battling an injury, correct?
She is. She had labrum surgery on her shoulder, so she has not been playing this year. But she is working hard, and her recovery is coming along, and she'll be back on the field next year.
And all these girls were captains at Greenwich High School, correct?
Correct.
Delaney Roth,
Cece Tauber, M.K. Savio, all were captains different years. It's great to go to a game and see girls that you've played with, now that you're playing against them.
And see parents that you've seen on the sidelines
exactly.
for years. I mean, going all the way back to youth lacrosse.
And that ball goes to Grayson Aslinson.
Grayson Aslinson to Lindsay Slanson. Messer running up the field. With the
and
pass
that's to
Dylan. McFerrin.
McFerrin, and she gets it to DiPietro, to Roth. And looks like they're not pressuring as much now.
Oh.
And that ball goes off of
the Greenwich stick,
Messer, yeah. And that's going to go to Weston. And a good redefend.
So Weston sent it back to their goalie again. There's some Weston players that are open in the midfield. Oh, nice hustle.
So I have a quick trivia question, see if you can answer this.
I'm supposed to be the one asking the trivia questions.
The Middlebury mascot is what?
Is a panther.
Now, what is the Williams mascot?
The Eefs.
So what exactly is an Eef? Can you answer that question? Families at home, feel free to call in if you know the answer to that question.
Is it some sort of goat?
I'm not sure. Is it a three-legged goat? I don't know.
Yeah, the Nescecs have some very interesting mascots. We've got polar bears. We've got Dumbos. I don't know if I was tough, so I'd want to be called a Dumbo. What's Amherst?
I don't know.
Gettysburg's the Bullets. St. Lawrence is the Saints.
Yes. And I will say, talking about St. Lawrence, they get a very cool tradition. A lot of these schools have really cool traditions that if a team is playing a game at home and they win, they've got a old bell, kind of like the bell that was Franklin Roosevelt? What's the Liberty, similar to the Liberty Bell. And a nice play there. Abazia finds McFerrin for the low shot, and that makes a score now, is it nine?
Gonna be 8-1.
8-1. So the tradition I was talking about is that the team will run up to this bell, which is centrally located in the middle of the athletic complex, and they ring that bell a couple of times as a team to let everybody on campus know that they were victorious in their game. I also think it lets the fraternities know that they should have a party that night.
I like that. I have another daughter who's a senior at Wake Forest, and they have an interesting tradition that after a basketball game, if they win, there is something called Roll the Quad that is completely supported by a club on campus that's funded by alums, that they literally just bring out tons of toilet paper and let them roll all the trees. And I can't imagine the manpower that goes into removing that toilet paper the next day. But it's a fun tradition, that's for sure.
No, that's the great thing about college, is each school has got their own unique fun tradition. And who knows how they actually started, but they continue to be perpetuated year after year.
David, is William and Mary different now than from when you were there?
Other than the buildings being a little bit nicer, I think some of the same traditions are, those that are politically correct are still intact.
Is that exciting to have two of your daughters play for your alma mater? As we've got Aubrey Roth, who will be attending William and Mary.
It is. It gives me, it's a reason to go back down there. I've been able to reconnect with a lot of old friends and a lot of old teammates. Interesting about William and Mary is obviously it's part of Colonial Williamsburg. So, nothing is going to change there. So you kind of feel like you can go walk down the main street, Duke of Gloucester, in the middle of Colonial Williamsburg, and it was the same when I was there as it is now. And So that's kind of cool. Though my fraternity is no longer on campus.
But neither are a lot, yeah. Sort of speaking of traditions, this past weekend at Middlebury, the 2004 women's lacrosse team came back as they had won the national championship that year. And it was really fun to see the 2004 team mix with the 2024 team.
Ah, so it's amazing when you throw a question out there to the general audience, how quickly people respond. So we've just been notified that Williams College, which was established in 1793, was bequeathed by Colonel Ephraim Williams. Thus, the name
Ephraim.
Eaves. So Eaves is short for Ephraim. So I'm going to, from now on, refer to them as the William Ephraims.
I love how I came up with a goat.
Sometimes referred to as the purple cow, the Lady Eaves. There's a whole bunch of different things. But no, there is no goat. Well, purple cow is close.
Yeah, it's close.
You just don't know your farm animals.
It looks like it. Well, thank you for whoever shared that information.
That came straight from, I think, Riverside, the home of Melissa Fry.
Thank you, Melissa.
And we've got 5:29 to go in the half. Abazia's taking the draw. And a nice hustle by number 6 from Weston. But that ball was checked away by Abazia out of bounds. So that ball will go to the Cardinals on the near sideline.
All right, Abazia giving the ball
Hannah
back
Cross
to Adorney.
Has done a good job getting the draw for Weston. It was the hustle of Abazia afterwards to knock it out of her stick. And that is Collier, who quickly brings it into the offensive end and gets it to Roth. And the Cardinals patiently work the ball. And here, starting to see Weston start to pressure out again. And there's Nagaki with the ball. It doesn't look like they actually pressure out as much up top as they do when the ball is behind or on the wings.
Oh, nice save.
And that was a nice save.
Weston goalie. Shot from Abazia, but save from the goalie.
So that looks like that's Christina Love is the goalie, if I'm not mistaken. And I guess she's only a junior, so she's okay. Committed to Vandy, but is not. Wow, I thought.
It's questionable defense.
Thought our player was fouled there, but no call.
It was good D, but it looked like she could have taken a little bit of a stick to the head. But the referees did not call anything, and the player's okay. Oh, too bad.
And that ball's going to go out of bounds, and looks like Flynn Tauber is going to pick that ball up. She quickly finds Giselle DiPietro, who brings it up the near side. Good hustle by DiPietro to get that ball across the midfield line.
Aubrey Roth to Collier. Collier to Abazia.
Abazia shoots.
Beautiful top. Oh, what do we have there?
I think we're going to have a dangerous shot on that or dangerous follow through on that. So the Cardinals are going to be down a player. Abazia is going to go in the box for 2 minutes. Cardinals will be down a player, so that will go until the 59-second mark of the half. And as we came to the conclusion a couple of games ago, yellow cards are not released in high school.
Correct. And when we talk about that, it's meaning after a goal. For example, if Weston was to score a goal, do we let our player come back in?
Good re-defend.
And that is not the case in high school.
Nice playing by the Cardinals. And that's Fry who's trying to get it. And Walt gets that ground ball.
Great hustle from Greenwich there.
And a good hustle from Weston to get that ball back.
I've noticed these two players on Weston's team a lot. Number five and six. Yeah.
They've been
pretty dominant in the midfield.
Two of the seniors, Sarah Zwack is number five and Hannah Cross.
So getting it into the stick of, is five Hannah Zwack?
That's a trick question. Yes, it is. Sarah Zwack.
Oh, Sarah Zwack, sorry.
And Hannah Cross.
Six is Hannah Cross. All right. And a goal for Weston.
And Weston takes advantage of that player advantage.
Now they've still got another 46 seconds on the clock before the Greenwich player is released from the penalty box.
Correct.
Let's
now
see
the
if they can take advantage of that
eight
again.
8-2. And it'll be interesting to see who's going to take the draw for the Cardinals with Abazia.
Yeah, good point. She's taken all of our draws today.
I'm going to guess it's going to be
Leighton Collier. Oh.
Yep. Actually, looks like Kate Adorney, senior captain Kate Adorney, taking the draw. She's heading up to Chestnut Hill, Boston College next year. And a good job by Adorney. And that ball is picked up by
number six.
And we've got 32 seconds to go in the
player
advantage, the man up. Is that still considered politically correct to call it man up?
Probably.
And they're getting a shooting space call. And we've got 19 seconds to go in the player advantage for Weston.
All right, Katie Janis ready.
And who's taking that? Who's got the ball? Is that number six? Is that Hannah Cross with it?
Could be.
And a nice save by Janis. And she finds Tauber. Tauber brings it up the far sideline.
You know, Tauber is a former attack player, so her ball handling skills are pretty good for a defender.
Now Flynn took that one for the team. As far as knowing, last year the Cardinals graduated all of their senior defenders.
And she's doing a great job on defense. In fact, I might even like her more on defense than I did on attack.
Yeah, she's definitely one of the leaders on that defensive unit.
Mm-hmm. I feel like nobody gets by her.
And we've got 23 seconds left to go.
All right, nice play by Grayson Islanton. She was able to
looked up and saw Grace coming right at her. We got 11 seconds to go in the half. No need. And that's Kali who gets the ball. She's just going to run out the clock. And
right,
so after one half of play, Cardinals lead by a score of 8-2. Going to take a moment to thank all the supporters, sponsors of the Girls Lacrosse program at Greenwich High School. We've got our premier sponsors, which are ONS, Performance Optimal Health, Summer Rain Sprinklers, the infamous Warrior Lacrosse, which is headed by Pat Jackson. We also have, did I say Performance Optimal Health? I did. Okay. Pizza Post is one of our silver sponsors, as well as State Farm Insurance, Lou Pataco, Attorney at Law, USA Bank. Splash Car Wash is one of our gold sponsors. So all of these local businesses partnering up with Greenwich High School to allow us to bring you a enhanced broadcast and bring a value-added proposition to the Greenwich High School girls lacrosse program. So we thank you for your support and your partnership. And I don't know if you want to say anything. Take a quick 6-minute break. We want a little recap.
Yeah, no,
sing
I think
a song, another.
I think with the music going, we might get tuned out. But I'll just give you a quick recap in terms of goals and assists. Greenwich has 8 goals, and we've had 7 players contribute to that, including Emma Abazia, Leighton Collier, Giselle DiPietro, Aubrey Roth with both an assist and a goal, Sophie DiPietro, and Lily Nagaki, again, the freshman with 2 assists. So it's been spread out, and we will be back to you in about 5 minutes for the second half of this game.
Great. And we're getting back to live action. It's the start of the second half. Cardinals leading by a score of 8-2. The lights are a little bit brighter right now. Abazia taking the draw for the Cardinals. DeGennaro and McFerrin on the circle for the Cardinals. I don't think the sun is now a factor in anybody's eyes. Good. This is a draw control win by the Cardinals.
All right, we're back for the start of the second half.
Yeah.
8-2, Greenwich leading Weston. Oh, great move from the Weston goalie, who is now out of the goal and being chased by Sophie DiPietro.
So Hannah Cross, one of the players for that we've been talking about from Weston, is committed to go play lacrosse at Lehigh. And that is from, we've got like a group of fans at home that have stacks of encyclopedias and sit by their computers, and they are able to answer all of these questions that come out throughout a broadcast. So it does take a village.
Thank you to all of our listeners.
I think right now we might be up to like 1.5 million listeners throughout the country.
I think there was a big jump when you added the female perspective.
I've got to be honest with you. We had to go back and forth with management, and you almost didn't get the job. But there was no one else who applied, so they had to give it to you. And a player went down. We're going to get a stoppage of play. There was no foul called on the play. I don't know who that is.
Did a ball deflect off the post and hit her?
I'm not sure. She's okay. I think maybe she got the wind knocked out of her.
Wow, the referee is getting this moving along quickly.
So the
is this player okay?
So I've been informed that the two girls that we've been talking a lot about, number 5 and number 6, Hannah Cross and Sarah Zwack, Sarah Zwack, I believe, is going to be playing actually next year at UNH, and Hannah, obviously, at Lehigh. So certainly some girls playing at the next level. Cardinals have got... That was a nice move by Roth in the feed to Abazia, and
oh,
good job by
Grayson Aslonson.
Yes,
right. She got in there and had the ball on her stick for a second, but then was swarmed by the
good play.
Players.
Good play by Grace O'Connor, getting her stick in the air to knock that pass out of the lane.
Got some wheels from Tauber.
Nice play by Tauber, who gets it to Roth, and they bring it into the offensive end, and then they settle it down.
All right, let's see what Weston defense is doing now. It does look like they are still playing with that.
They are looking.
Backer D.
Yep. And that was a slash cut by Fry. And that hard bounce shot went over. And in the meantime, Nagaki gets her third assist on the feed to Roth for the goal. And that makes it 9-2.
Lily Nagaki on fire with the assist today.
You know, head up, moving the ball, good things happen.
Two goals for Aubrey Roth today. I'm sorry, that is two goals. I'm sorry. Three goals.
Who's
no
counting?
No wonder my numbers weren't adding up. But thank you.
And a good draw by Abazia. She gets it to Cardinals unable to pick up that ground ball. Collier pressing out.
Grayson and Swanson better watch that 3 seconds.
And a nice anticipation play by Abazia, who jumps in the passing lane. Goalie, senior goalie Kate Janis, who's going to Smith College, we haven't even mentioned that, has really had a solid performance today, both in the net and also on her outlet passes.
All right, the ball is in the stick of Abazia. We've got a lot of cutters coming through the 8-meter right now.
And that's Nagaki with the ball. And that's going to be a foul.
Kind of surprised she's not getting a yellow card there.
I know. There's actually been one yellow card, right? That was it today. So
one far. Yellow card for the dangerous propel.
Yep. Cardinals waiting to see if they're going to come out and pressure the ball. That should open things up on the opposite side of the field if they press out. Nice. Good feed by Abazia, who finds a cutting DiPietro with the goal.
Again, it was that same thing, David, where the person was able to get behind the backer and receive that pass and score.
And it all started as the Cardinals kind of kept the ball patiently on the outside. And Weston, who's obviously needs to get the ball back, started to press out, and that opened up the middle.
All right, we've got a score of 10-2, Greenwich High School, with 6:17 left in the third quarter. Sun is setting here in Weston. Who do we have? Is this Abazia taking the draw again?
Yes, yep. And looks like Giselle DiPietro is on the circle with Annabelle DiGennaro, who's also got a sister on the team, who's a goalie,
yes. A
twin sister.
Finley DiGennaro.
We're the only team in the FCAC to have two sets of twins playing. In fact, it could be a world record. Last year we had two sets of twins.
I don't know. Maybe somebody listening at home could do some research on that for us.
Do we have anybody know if we have any twins coming in next year? Because the DiPietros and the DiGenneros will still be on the team next year.
Can you imagine three sets of twins?
Oh, I know we're not allowed to recruit at Greenwich High School, but we are looking for another set of girl lacrosse twins to join our team next year.
World record book.
The Guinness Book of World Records. It would be interesting if you can only have three names, you know, just back and forth. And that's all you had to say.
DiPietro DiGennaro, Gennaro DiPietro, DiPietro DiGennaro.
Exactly. and back again.
All right, we've got Weston working the ball around number six.
We're under 5 minutes to go.
Looks like we might have a turnover here.
Oh, and a good hustle play by...
by Grayson Islanson. Oh, and a red ball. Nice, Grayson.
Oh, and I have been informed that we could potentially have the Barber twins coming to Greenwich High School next year, who are lacrosse players. And if you really want a fun fact, their brothers played at Greenwich High School, and their cousin plays at William Mary with my daughter. Enough of the fun facts. We got a lacrosse game going on. And that was, looks like Lindsay Messer. I think they called her for starting soon, but I thought you'd just kind of pick up and go. And good swarming defense by the Cardinals to shut down that fast break, led by Tauber on that.
All right, Weston working the ball around. Oh,
good play. That was Rachel Civitello who tipped that out.
I think that went off, red stick, so it's going to go back to White. But good try there for the interception. Rachel Civitello is a junior on this team. I have to say, watching her in preseason, she's one of the faster players on the team.
Yes, she is.
So she could do a great job with the clears here.
And she actually was playing midfield on the draw circle last weekend and did a really nice job.
Oh, good defense from Greenwich here.
Yeah, that was a nice double between Tauber and DeGennaro on the ball.
Keep her out. Oh, nice. And Grayson Islanson picks that ball up. Let's see if she can clear it out.
You sure you don't want to say, sure it's not pronounced Aslinson? I'm only kidding there, Con.
Both Grayson's parents attended Greenwich High School.
There's DiPietro, who gets that ball into the offensive end. Finds Roth. And that was a nice pass by Roth to Van Oss. And the Vanderbilt commit gobbles that one up, and Weston quickly looks to clear it. I'd be curious to know how many girls on the team knew before the game that they were facing a lefty goalie.
Well, do they do much scouting?
I don't know if they do. This is not a team that they regularly play.
You know, and it's hard to adjust to that when you're so used to the majority of the goalies being right-handed. You know, all of a sudden you shoot that ball right into their stick and you're like, oh, I forgot she was a lefty.
I will admit it took me when I used to play at least 3/4 to figure that out.
Oh, nice save from Janice, even though there was a whistle before that. But
and
beautiful
we're
save.
Approaching a minute to go in the quarter. So we're actually giving out an award today to the fan who's watching this broadcast who's the furthest away in actual miles. You'll win a high schooler at, what's the place in Old Greenwich? Chicken
Garden Catering.
Garden Catering, right?
All right, Lindsay Messer coming up
Messer
with that
comes
ground
up
ball.
With a ground ball. She's clearing it. There's 31 seconds left.
I will say Lindsay Messer has some good wheels herself. And, oh, we had a fast break. Oh, yes, beautiful. We had the option for the third pass to Aubrey Roth, but Giselle DiPietro took that to goal and had a beautiful shot. And the score is now 11-2.
And 21.6 seconds to go. So just in regards to that contest – I have been notified that we have a viewer in New Zealand. I don't know how we're going to get you the high schooler, but we might have to, I don't know, put it in like frozen dry ice and ship it out. I'm not 100% sure.
Well, I'd love to know who the viewer is in New Zealand, their relation to the Greenwich High School girls lacrosse team, and what time is it in New Zealand?
Yeah, because I know there are a lot of these, a lot of, how I like to call them, couch fans at home in old Greenwich who were hoping they were just going to shoot down the road and get that free high school for dinner tonight. I'm sorry. It's not going to be that easy.
Wow, but thank you to the fan watching all the way from New Zealand. That's dedication to be watching at this hour. Oh, red ball.
I don't know. I've got to ask a question. What's further away, Alabama or New Zealand? It's a rhetorical question. I think I know the answer. And that, friends, is the end of the third quarter with the Cardinals leading by a score of 11-2. Any trivia this evening?
My biggest commentary for this evening would be that Greenwich seems to be doing a very good job on the defensive end. They're putting a lot of pressure on the ball throughout the midfield as well as when it gets into the Wilton attacking side. And Weston. And I think Weston's having a little bit of a tougher time figuring out what's the best defense to play against our team today. So in my opinion, that would be the biggest difference between this game, would be the way the defense is playing.
And Greenwich is playing very unselfish lacrosse. They're patiently working the ball, not really forcing anything. And, you know, the more pressure they get from Weston, it makes it easier if they keep moving the ball. And they've been able to identify early on some weaknesses underneath. And we've had a number of assisted goals.
Yeah, good point, David. Not to take anything away from our attack, because you're absolutely right. They have been able to take advantage of the Weston sort of struggling a little bit with their defense. And as you said, move the ball and have a lot of assisted goals today. In fact, I am just looking of our goals, all but two of them have been assisted.
There you go. So I think we should thank our sponsors again. And I failed to mention one of our premier sponsors the last time we spoke, and that is, if you look at the girls on our team, our girls are a very healthy bunch of girls. And that's because they get well fed when they go to Rinaldi's Country Deli. And I think they helped provide some sandwiches on the bus today. So our premier sponsors are obviously our ONS. And I'll give a big shout out to Dr. Paul Sethi. I think he might have single-handedly patched up, stitched up all of the girls in my family at one time or other. Performance Optimal Health. If you ever get injured, they're a good group to go see. They've been a huge partner of ours, doing ACL screening, talking about athletic nutrition. Just great, great people over there. We've got Summer Rain, keeping the lawns in Greenwich nice and green. Certainly Warrior Lacrosse and Pat Jackson. A number of these girls started their lacrosse playing for him.
Yeah, I was really impressed with performance this spring. The amount of time they took to get our entire, not only just varsity team, but I think program.
The whole program.
Into their office to individually go through with each one of them some screening about injury prevention, and provided each of the girls after that meeting with a very detailed report of exercises they could do, where they had deficiencies, and, I mean, above and beyond. So thank you to Performance for that.
Yeah. And if you are have a daughter who plays on one of the Greenwich High School lacrosse programs, if you're the parents of an alumni, or if you are an alumni and would like to make a donation and give back to the program, feel free to go onto our website. No donation is too small, and certainly no donation is too large. That looks like we've got some couple new players, and then number 16, Lexi Carino, in there on defense right now. One of the juniors, actually one of the co-captains next year of the Greenwich High School girls ice hockey team.
Who else do we have on this team from the ice hockey team? Aubrey Roth, I believe. Is she also going to be a captain next year?
She's another captain.
Oh, the two DiPietro. Well, one DiPietro is on the team as a goalie, right? And the other one was maybe the manager?
She was injured, so she was the manager, yeah. But the fun story is that Sophie DiPietro, never having played ice hockey before, let alone was not a great skater, volunteered to play goalie for the Greenwich High School girls varsity ice hockey team and did a phenomenal job.
Oh, and I think to quote her mom, she said, oh, she just found this sport too late. I think she loved playing on the ice hockey team.
No, it's a good group of girls. Very tight-knit group, quite similar to the Greenwich High School girls lacrosse team.
Well, that was a nice move by number six.
And Janice
the ball.
Grabs
that
ball.
We got a quick outlet.
And she looks and finds DiGennaro in the middle. And she's got some space. And
she's got
another
some
one of the.
Too.
She's got some wheels. She gets it into the offensive end.
We've got about 9.5 minutes left in the game. The score is 11-2, Greenwich versus Weston.
Now, I've got to ask a question. She got hit. I would have thought that might have been a yellow card, but I'm taking a guess that potentially the girl checked her own stick into her face. Because the rule in women's lacrosse, any hit to the head is a yellow card.
Wow, what a catch from Aubrey Roth. Wow. Aubrey had an amazing catch there, and then it took the shot, and it sailed a little bit over the goal, but nice effort there.
And that was Nagaki who picked up the rebound. That's McFerrin with the ball. And that pass was to Collier, and she got steamrolled from behind on that one.
Looks like she's going to take a hash. Free position pretty much from the middle of the circle. Let's see if she can keep the...
This is a good hash for a right-hander.
See if she can remember the whole lefty thing we talked about. Oh, she decided to pass it. Wow, very unselfish move.
Finds Roth. And that is a goal. And that should make it, isn't it, 12-2, I thought? I would think. Yeah, 12-2.
Yeah.
And so this is a setup question in women's lacrosse. When you have a 10-goal differential, what happens?
Well, I know in collegiate lacrosse it goes to running clock. Is that the same in high school
lacrosse? The same in high school.
Okay. So 8 minutes running clock right now, as long as the score stays by a 10-goal differential.
Or the store stays open.
Yeah, I just want to give a shout-out to Leighton Collier there. She had a pretty clear shot to goal.
That was a rather unselfish play and a smart play, which shows a high lacrosse IQ.
Yes, agree. There's some discussion amongst the referees
and
about the
problem,
draw right now.
And in the meantime, the clock is continuing to run. I would have thought that they would have stopped the clock for that discussion amongst themselves. Go, That was Emma Van Oss who took the draw, and that was picked up by Sarah Zwack. And
all right, Weston passing the ball around the well outside the 12-meter. Greenwich defense on their toes, working hard.
But you can notice the difference in defensive style between what Greenwich is playing right now and what Weston's been doing all game. Cardinals are pretty content right now to kind of plant their heels on the 8-meter. And that was a nice play. When the Cardinal players slid early, left the girl wide open in the middle. And
yeah, we actually had sent a defender defender behind in that one, which we don't always do.
No.
So maybe that was a little bit of the difference there. But very nice shot coming from Weston. I'm not sure who scored that. Do you know?
I don't.
Okay.
But I'm going to take a guess. It might have been 5 or 6.
All right. Score of 12-3. And the clock is no longer running.
Nope. And allows us to be out here just a little bit longer. Looks like Emma Van Oss, a freshman, is going to be taking the draw.
So we've got right now, David, 3 freshmen on the circle for Greenwich High School. DeGennaro, Van Oss, and Nagaki.
Close your eyes and open up, and there's your future. It's great to see. Greenwich Cardinals have a relatively young team this year.
And from what I hear, a good pipeline, too. According to the Greenwich Youth Lacrosse 8th grade team, there's some very strong players in that class.
I just got their newsletter with their recruiting highlights. One of our own, Sarah O'Connor, her daughter, Grace, one of the captains. Sarah helps run the girls program for GYL. It's a thankless job, and she does a great job.
Weston just overthrew a ball that went out, and Greenwich was able to pick it up.
And that is Rachel Civitello with the ball, and she gets it into the offensive end. She gets that to Sophie DiPietro, gets it behind to Roth.
It's nice to see Mary Kate Fry back on the field after she battled an injury starting during preseason.
That actually injury goes back to almost, she did that last year. It's been a long, one of these nagging injuries that I thought, that she had thought had been healed. But it's good that she's out there, she's playing.
I think it's always important to have captains on the field.
She had a nice goal last game also. It was a good look by Fry inside to McFerrin and a nice defensive play by Weston.
Yeah, hard angle for McFerrin to shoot. Oh, Roth on the re-defend. Got DeGennaro, nice job stopping her.
And we're approaching 4 minutes to go in the quarter.
Well, this has been a good game for Greenwich. Despite the score, they've had to adjust to some different things. And hopefully this will lead to some confidence going into the Wilton game tomorrow, which should be a very tough game for Greenwich.
You know, they talk about it in ice hockey, and it's a nice save meanwhile by Janice on that, something that they call time and space. And that's the amount of time that you have to do something with the ball before that defender has taken up that space and is on you. And against the better teams, you've got less time and less space to make a decision. And you'll notice that difference tomorrow in tomorrow's game when they go play against the better team in Wilton. And that's a nice clear right now by Tauber.
Yeah, just to go back to that, that was Civitello with a great interception behind the goal. She got it quickly to Janice, who quickly got it out
that was
to
a
the
shot,
midfield.
That was fried or off, and that shot was gobbled up by the Vandy commit.
Oh.
And nice ground ball by
DiPietro. DiPietro to her sister, Sophie. Greenwich going back into
the attacking
zone.
I wonder what the discussions are at the table. Hey, I was wide open. How come you didn't pass me the ball?
Well, did you have that with your girls when they were both playing at Greenwich High School?
My girls, one was a defender, one was an attacker, so I didn't have that.
Oh. Yeah, thank God I had one girl who played lacrosse and one who decided to run track. That was even better.
And we're close to 2 minutes left to go.
McFerrin with some good stick skills there to weave in and out of some defenders. Oh, they've got some sort of weave going up top. Oh, I like this. Let's see. Oh, good idea.
That was a good shot by, that was
Leighton
Collier.
Collier.
Did that go off the pipe or was it saved by the goalie?
It was a save by the goalie, but it was some good ball movement.
Yep. And Messer chases that one down, keeps it in. And a good re-defend by the Cardinals puts pressure on Weston.
A minute 20 left in the game. I would imagine for the girls on the field, this is almost perfect weather for lacrosse.
Without a doubt. Now that the sun's down, they're not having to deal with looking into their eyes with the sun, but the weather's nice. Another save by Janice.
God, she's a tall girl, and she has had so many great low saves today.
She's looking for the she was looking for the long outlet pass.
Oh, DiPietro to DiPietro.
And we're approaching 30 seconds.
All right, sounds like they have a play set up called Miami. Let's see if they can score with 27 seconds left on the clock. Not by any means do we need this goal at this point in the game, but maybe they just want to practice a play in anticipation of tomorrow.
And that was a nice look. And the shot was by Sophie DiPietro on the pass from her sister. I'm sure there'll be some discussion.
Ooh, right off the
good try there. Shot by Grace O'Connor. And that's going to do it, folks. So I'm going to also want to, I'd be remiss in not saying a quick hello and a shout out to Joe Michelli, who's one of the assistant coaches here at Weston. His daughter, Bella, played lacrosse with my older daughter, and she's currently a defender at St. Joe's, and they've got a big game tomorrow against Davidson. But Joe is one of the, how can you put it? I think everyone's a good guy, but he's definitely one of the good guys.
The girls are lucky to have him.
Without a doubt. So the final score?
The final score, I believe, was 12-3. I don't know if you want to do a quick shout-out to our Greenwich coaches.
So our Greenwich coaches, I think we all know who they are. But if you're just tuning in or haven't tuned into the game, head coach Tara Clow, assistant coach Kristen Schmidt, and other assistant coach Andrew Morton. Tara Clow's got a number of daughters that play. Two that are at Sacred Heart, and the youngest is plays in the youth program at New Canaan. Andrew Morton is a Greenwich townie, grew up here, and has graciously given his time to our program. And Coach Schmidt, this is her first year with the program, grew up in Pleasantville.
She also played Division II lacrosse, I believe.
She did, and was a coach, I think, last year at West Hill. So we're glad to have her. The girls I know are glad to have her. So I think on that note, I want to wish everybody a safe ride home. Thanks for tuning in. Unfortunately, Dave Adorney in Alabama, you did not win the high schooler. But keep on trying and keep on calling. And thanks to Mike, our cameraman. On that, we're going to sign out.
Good night.
Yeah, tomorrow we've got I'm not gonna be I'm gonna be at Gettysburg.
Is Wilton though doing a live stream?
They use the huddle or something like that. So
well, thank you.